Hello everyone, the topic is Stoffelmayer Universal Matrix Band Retainer from Metricing System in Conservative Dentistry. So now what exactly is Metricing System? Metricing is nothing but creating a temporary wall opposite to the axial wall in the case of class 2. Now for example, this is your tooth and there's a caries which is present in the proximal area. So when you do the tooth preparation, that is for the class 2, so what you do is you break off that proximal wall. So this is the tooth preparation which you make for your class 2. Now, to get that wall again, to get that contact with the adjacent tooth, what you do is you place a matrix band around this tooth and you create that tooth contact with it. So this is nothing but metricing system. So they are used whenever one or more walls of the tooth they are missing, and they help to establish the proper anatomic contour and the proximal contacts without any gingival overhangs. So there are various designs of metricing system which is available, and the most commonly used ones are the ivory bands and the Stoffelmayer. So we are going to see in this video about the Stoffelmayer Universal Matrix Band Retainers. Stoffelmayer is known because it is designed by Dr. B.F. Stoffelmayer, and it is also known as a universe metricing system. Now because it can be used in all types of preparation of the posterior teeth. So the indication for this Stoffelmayer is, so it is used in a class 1 tooth preparation in which you have to do the buccal and the lingual extension. The next is the unilateral or bilateral class 2. So it is used in a class 2 tooth preparation in which it can be unilateral or bilateral. So bilateral is nothing but it is known as more tooth preparation. It can also be used in class 2 compound tooth preparation, which is having more than 2 missing walls. So this is because of all these indications, it is known as the universal matrix band. Now what are the advantages? So advantages of this Stoffelmayer is, it is easy to use, then it is sturdy and stable in nature, it provides good contact and contours, then it can be easily removed, it can be sterilized as it is made up of stainless steel, so you can sterilize it and you can reuse it again and again. Then the price, it is very inexpensive, then it can be used from both the sides, that is facial as well as the lingual side. Now what are the disadvantages? So disadvantages are, it cannot be used in a badly broken teeth or a extensive class 2 restoration. Now if the tooth, it is badly broken, so now in this Stoffelmayer you take the support from the adjacent walls of your tooth or the remaining walls of the tooth which is present. So in case where the tooth, it is badly broken, so in that case you cannot use the Stoffelmayer. The next is, it does not offer optimal contour and contact for the posterior resin restoration. Now this Stoffelmayer, it is very good in the case of amalgams, but it has some limitation in the case of resins restorations. Now what are the types of the Stoffelmayer? So they are divided into two types, like based on the type of head and based on the type of dentition. So now this head, it is nothing but it is a part of your Stoffelmayer. So this portion of your Stoffelmayer, it is known as head. So in this, it can be straight or it can be angulated. Now the one which we commonly used are the ones which are straight. So they are, the head, it is in straight angle. And it can be placed only from the buccal side. So whenever you are placing your Stoffelmayer, you have to place it on the buccal side towards the cheek. And you cannot place the normal one in the lingual side. Now the contra angle one, it is angulated. So this head, it is angulated and it can be placed from both the sides, that is buccal and the lingual side. The next is, depending on the type of dentition, it can be standard or small. So standard, it can be used in the permanent teeth, and small, it is used in the primary teeth in children. Now what are the parts of this Stoffelmayer? So this Stoffelmayer, it is divided into various parts. So over here, this portion, it becomes your head. Over here, this is the locking vise which has this diagonal slot. Now you can see this slot, it is in the diagonal direction. So it has this diagonal direction. Over here, this is the pointed spindle. This is the large curl nut and this is the small curl nut. This is your frame, because it provides the framework to whole of your Stoffelmayer. So this is the frame. So these are the various parts of the Stoffelmayer. So first is head. So head, it uses the slot for positioning of the matrix. Now over here, this is the head. So you are placing your band from this portion, that is the head. Then it is a U-shaped head with two slots in the open side. Now this is the closed side of your head and this is the open side of your head. So this is like a U-shape. Now you can see the shape of this head. So it is a U-shaped head and it has slots over here. Now you can see they have this two slots in this open side of your head, and the open side of head, it should be faced gingivally. Now this is a very commonly asked question in your vivas, like what are the three basic principles of the Stoffelmayer? So first is, the head, it is placed, so this open portion of your head, open side of your head, it is placed gingivally over here like this. If it is a mandibular teeth, So it is placed like this, and if it is a maxillary teeth, it is placed like this. So this open side, it goes in the gingival direction. And the next is, the next principle is, this is placed buccally and it is placed outside the mouth. Now you cannot place this like this into the patient's throat. So you have to place it outside the mouth and it is placed in the buccal direction, that is towards the cheek. The next is the locking wise. So it has this, so this is the locking wise and it has this diagonal slot. So this portion, it is located near the head. So you can see over here. So it is located near to the head for the installation of the band in the retainer. So now you can see over here, the band, it goes from this diagonal slot and it helps in the placement of the band around the tooth. So this is the pointed spindle. So it is known as pointed because the tip is pointed, and hence it is known as pointed spindle. So it is used to adjust the distance between the head and the locking vise. So over here, it helps in the adjustment of the, now you can see over here, when we are moving it, so this locking vise, it is coming closer to your head. So when we move it counterclockwise, it is going away. So the distance, so it is helping in the adjustment of the distance between the head and the locking vise, and it also helps to adjust the size of the loop. Now how I'm going to explain when we'll see about the placement, like how exactly you place the Stoffelmayer. The next part is curled nuts. So they are large and small. So over here, this one is a large one and this one is a smaller one. So this larger nut, it is used to adjust the size of the loop. So this is used to adjust the size of the loop. Now when we place our band, so this is the loop which we form in this band. So this is adjusted with the help of this large nut. The next is the small one. So small one is, turning this nut clockwise, it tightens the point spindle against the band and thus it secures the band in the retainer, and the reverse position, it releases the spindle, and because of that it releases the band. So it is like when you're moving it in the clockwise direction, it tightens up the band with the retainer, and when you're moving it in the counterclockwise, then it loosens it up. So how it is, we are going to see in the placement of it. Now the next is the assembly, like how are you going to assemble this retainer. So when the band and the retainer, they are assembled, two ends of the band, it must be of the same length, which is protruding from the diagonal slot. So this is your matrix band. So when you're placing this band into this retainer, so it should be like this, two end, it should be at the same point. It should not be like this, like one point is like ahead of the other end. So now when we place it through this diagonal slot, now you can see over here, so they are at the same length. It's not like one is going ahead of the other. So they should be at the same length. The next is the loop, which is extending from the retainer. It can be of the following ways. So now this is the loop, which is extending from your diagonal slot and then from your head. So it can be in the various types. So it can be straight, or it can be tilted towards the right or towards the left. So this is right and left. It is used when you're using this in the posterior area. And straight is when you are using this retainer in the anterior teeth. Now this right and left, it again depends on the quadrant, whether you are working on the right side or whether you are working on the left side. Now how we do that is, so first what you do is you place this band in the diagonal slot, and then, so when you have to extend it in the straight manner, so what you do is you go through both of the slots which are present, and like this it becomes straight. Now you can see over here, so it is going straight way. Now for the right and left is, first you are going to place it in the diagonal slot, and then what you do is, rather than going from both the slots, what you do is you place this into only one slot and then you bend it from this open end. So over here, this becomes your right sided, and then you place it from this side, then it becomes your left sided. So when it is from left or right side, you don't go through this second slot over here, and only in the straight one you go through this second slot. So this is how you do the placement for the band in the straight and right and left ways. Then the loop of the matrix band, it appears as a funnel shape. So this is the loop of your band. So it appears as a funnel shape. Now what are the types of band that you use? So types of band, it can be flat and pre-contoured. So the ones which we are using is the one which is flat. Now as I have assembled it, so because of that it has like deformed a bit. So basically your band, it is completely straight and it is a flat type of band that we are using mostly in the colleges. So this flat bands, it is available in two sizes or two thicknesses, that is 0.002 inches or 0.0015 inches, and they are available in three shapes, that is number one, which is a universal type, then number two, it is used in the case of MODs, and number three, it is used, like it has the same application of that of number 2, but it is a narrower one. And this number 2, it is usually used in the case of molars. Then the flat band, it needs to be contoured before placing in the retainer. So what you need to do is you are using a ball burnisher and then you burnish it. You contour it properly according to the contour of your tooth. And the next one is a pre-contour or a pre-formed. So in the normal one, we only are forming the loop. But now in the pre-contour one, these loops are already formed and they are available in different sizes depending on the size of your tooth. So these are the like basically three types of your bands. Now starting with the most important thing, that is the placement of the Teufelmeyer retainer and the band. So we'll see them in step by step, like how exactly you do the placement of it. So first point is, first open the large curl nut so that the slide is at least 1/4 inches from the head, and you're moving this large nut counterclockwise direction. So this is your large nut. So what you do is you're going to place it at least, so this is the distance from your head till this point. So what you're going to do is you're going to place this head, which is 1/4 of this distance. So it should be like 1/4 at your height from the head. So you're going to move it counterclockwise in the opposite direction. So this is how it is. So now you can see over here, the placement of it is at least 1/4 of the distance from the head. The next step is, then you're going to hold this large curl nut with one hand, then you're going to open this small nut in the opposite direction, that is again counterclockwise, for the clearance of the diagonal slot from the reception of the matrix band. Now what does it mean? So first we have done this arrangement in which it is 1/4. So now the distance between your locking wise and the head, it is 1/4 of the total length. The next point is, now you're going to hold this large nut with the other hand, that is your non-working hand, and you're going to move this small curl nut in the counterclockwise direction. Now why are you doing this? Now when we are moving it in the counterclockwise direction, now you can see the spindle, it was present over here, and when we are moving it in the counterclockwise direction, this spindle, it is going away from that. So now you can see over here, now it is not visible over here. Now why it is? Because now when you place your band, so if this nut, now if this spindle, it is present, so it becomes very difficult to place the band into this diagonal slot because of the, so now you can see over here, it becomes difficult to place the band into this diagonal slot. So because of that, you keep it completely free so that now you can place the band like easily into this diagonal slot. So this is the next point, that you are going to hold the large nut and then you're going to open this small nut into the counterclockwise direction. Why? To clear this space so that your band, it goes easily into this diagonal slot. So this is the first part, that what you're going to do for your retainer. The next is, now the two ends of the matrix band, they are secured together to form a loop, or you can use a preformed ones. Basically preformed, they are rarely used. The ones which are commonly used are the flat ones. So what you're going to do is, now these are the, so it will be available, so this band, flat band, it is available as a straight line, so like this it is available. So then you're going to fold it and you're going to secure the two ends of your band and you're going to form this loop. So this is the next point. Then what you're going to do is you're going to place the end of this band in the diagonal slot and you're going to turn the loop wherever you want, whether it is right, left, or it is straight. Now I have shown you like how exactly you do that right, left, and straight thing. So now this is your diagonal slot. So the first is, you're going to place this band into this diagonal slot, and for example we want a straight, like we are working on the anterior teeth, so we are going to place it in the straight manner. So this is the placement for your anterior teeth. Now you can see it is completely gone into this slot, it is completely engaged into this slot too. So this is how it is for now. Then what you're going to do is, then the small curl nut, it is tightened to secure the band. So now we have seen in the parts that this nut, it secures the band. So what you're going to do is you're going to move this in the clockwise direction slowly, and then you will feel that resistance. So now what you're doing is you're securing your band. So now you'll see that the screw, it is not moving when you feel that complete resistance. Now you'll see, so we are removing it, so this is not getting removed. So it had got completely secured with the help of this small curl nut. So now it is completely engaged, or it is secured into this retainer. Now you can see, even if I'm pulling it, it is not coming out because it is like secured properly into this retainer. The next is, so after securing the band, this retainer, it is placed around the tooth to be restored. So for example, if we have this tooth to be restored, so if we have a class 2 in this case, so what you're going to do is you're going to loosely place this over this tooth. So first you're going to loosely place this over this tooth. So now this is, now you can see over here, it is very loosely fitted. So what you're going to do is the slotted side, it is positioned gingivally. So we have seen that in the part of head, that this part, so this open ended, it is placed in the gingival direction. So this is our, this is for example a mandibular tooth. So in this case, what we are going to do is we are going to place it in the gingival direction. So over here now you can see this is the covered, like rounded portion, so it is coming on the occlusal surface. Then what you're going to do is, for the final adaptation of this matrix band to the tooth, what you're going to do is you're going to tighten the large skull nut. So you're going to move this large nut in the clockwise direction to tighten it up through the circumference of the tooth. So you're going to move it like this in the clockwise direction. Now you can see the size of the loop, it is reducing and it is getting properly secured. So this is how it is. Now it is properly secured. So this is the complete placement of the Toffelmeyer to the tooth. Then you're going to finally check the contour with the help of mirror, whether it is like following that proper contour. Then you can use a burnisher for contouring it properly. And finally, then you're going to position the wedge, and this becomes like the complete wedging and matricing for the Toffelmeyer. Now this is the restoration. So basically we have done the restoration in this case. The next is the removal of this retainer. Now how are you going to remove this retainer? So first what you're going to do is you're going to move, or you're going to turn this small curl nut in the counterclockwise direction to release this spindle. So now our band, it was tightly contacted with this retainer. So to remove this, what we're going to do is we're going to move this smaller one in the counterclockwise direction. Now your band, it is getting loosened up. So your band, now it is getting loosened up. Then what you're going to do is, then you're going to move the large nut, which is moved in the counterclockwise direction, to loosen the band. So now after moving that large nut in the counterclockwise direction, so you, what you do is, now then you're going to, so this retainer, it becomes completely loosened up and you can easily remove this retainer. But now the band, it is on the same place where it was. So what you're going to do is, next the band, it is disengaged from the uninvolved proximal side. So for example, this is the side which we have not prepared. So first you're going to disengage it in the buccal or the lingual direction. You're not going to just, you have to remember this very well, that you're not going to push it in the occlusal direction, because if you do this, then there are chances that your restoration which you have done, it can get fractured. So you have to move this band in the buccal or the lingual direction. And always you have to remember that whenever you're removing this band, then you have to keep your finger on this restoration on the occlusal surface. So when you're removing it, so that your restoration, it doesn't come with this band itself. So this is the point that you have to remember, that you're not going to pull this band in the occlusal direction. You're going to move it in buccal or the lingual direction, and slowly, slowly you're going to remove this. And you have to always support your restoration occlusally so that it doesn't get fractured. Then you're going to remove it from the restored side by moving gently it in the buccal direction. So this is how you're going to remove the retainer and the band. So first you're going to remove the retainer, and then you're going to remove the band in the buccal or the lingual direction, but you're not going to pull it like with a force in the occlusal direction. So this was all about the placement of how you're going to place the retainer and then how you're going to remove this retainer. And the last part of this is the modification to this Toffelmeyer. So it is known as Omni Matrix. So this is a disposable one, like you have to use this matrix only one time and then you have to dispose it off. And it is a pre-assembled Toffelmeyer retainer, and it is available with various thickness of the band, like it is 0.0010 and 0.0015 inches. So the advantage for this Omni is it takes less time to use because it is preformed, and the disadvantage is it is expensive. So this is just a modification, a very commonly asked Viva or the MCQ question that you should know. And that was all about the Toffelmeyer. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like. If you have any doubts, then comment, do share and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.